In this video, I will show how to select a reference sequence for your whole genome SNP analysis. The choice of a reference sequence is very important since only genomic information that is shared between the reference sequence and the sample sequences will be included in the analysis. First, I need to create a new sequence type experiment. To create a new experiment, I click on the green plus icon in the toolbar of the Sequence Types panel and I choose the sequence type option from the list. I specify a name and I check the reference sequence option in the last step. The experiment is added to the Experiment Types panel. A reference sequence might be a fully annotated genome sequence, for example, downloaded from an online repository, but could just as well be a de novo assembled sequence consisting of multiple contexts. There is a de novo assembled sequence present for one entry in the database. I will use the sequence as reference sequence by copying the sequence from the de novo experiment to our new sequence type experiment. I click on the green dot corresponding to the de novo experiment to call the sequence editor. I choose File Save As. And I highlight the new sequence type experiment before saving. The sequence is copied to our new sequence type experiment. Since this is the first sequence linked to our new sequence experiment, this sequence is automatically considered as the reference sequence for this experiment. I double-click on the whole genome SNP sequence type experiment to verify this. The reference sequence is indicated in the settings panel. This ends this video. Please tune in to our other whole genome SNP videos to learn more about the workflow in BioNumerics.